I've asked my old friend Woody to design a course that will push both of us to the limits of our abilities. After a distinguished career training elite soldiers to operate in hostile environments, Woody knows a thing or two about survival.
I'll be there for Nietzsche.
I'll be dropping Ed and EJ off on either sides of a jungle valley. They need to negotiate their way down through some steep cliffs to a river and then head downstream for about 50 to 60 kilometers. This will take them to their exfil point, which is a dam on the river.
We've both got a parang each and a sat phone, yeah? And then the camera kit.
That's it.
What's the main threats?
Plenty of scorpions, plenty of king cobras. There are tigers out there.
Well, that makes it interesting.
The entire environment is hostile. One thing that makes it even more dangerous is we're very, very remote. It was a long way to the nearest good medical facility.
This course is guaranteed to test Ed and EJ's ability to conquer extreme environments. Potentially, they could end up doing 120 kilometers if their navigation's not right. You'd expect the average person to do that in about 12 days. With their skill set and their abilities, I'm expecting them to do it under a week.
It's day three, and I'm smiling because I'm in the lead. The last thing I'm going to do, though, today is rest on my laurels. My intention is to widen the gap and make sure that EJ, by tonight, is miles behind me. The river is going down and around, and I'm wondering if I go over the saddle and down the other side, I could potentially save myself even more time for a cheeky little beast up the hill, down the other side. Job's a good one. I'm literally just using this, the handrail, up and over the little saddle in order to cut off that big looping meander. I could save myself, I reckon, about half a day. See you later, EJ. See you later.
Just looking at the tracker, it appears as heading up one of these little valleys, one little re-entrance. Ed's played, some would say, a smart game, some would say a dangerous game. If this goes well for him, he really is going to be ahead of EJ. If it doesn't go well and he gets turned around up there, he's going to be losing a lot of time.
Still making progress, and I can still see light through the top there, which means I'm 90% sure there is going to be a route straight through here.
The jungle has birthed a mountain in front of me. Steep. I gotta make a plan. I need to figure out a way around this. Hello! Ed, you in there? There's a cave here. Take a look. I've got no other choice at this point. That's where I'm going, into the abyss. This place is huge. I can't go in there without a light. I gotta see. I'm gonna try and figure something out.
There's no other way around. Oh. You can see the gully walls are becoming vertical at the side, which is not a good sign. I'm getting slightly pinned in between very, very sheer faces. I'm just starting to have that little bit of doubt in my mind as to whether this was actually the right call or not. But we're committed now, so we kind of got to do it, otherwise we'd have to backtrack and lose a stupid amount of time.
Generally heading in the direction I need to go, south. I don't know, you can get lost in caves, but there could be some food in here. Rats, snakes, they all come in here.
Something's just happened that we can't really explain at the moment. EJ has just disappeared. You know, it may be that his tracker's down, but the signal has just completely gone.
Smell the bat crap. Okay. got lucky and I got a bat. You know it's dinner. Sorry, little buddy. Well, I see trees. I got a way out. I finally got a break.
EJ's just popped up on our screens again. It could be a technical hitch, but whatever the reason, it's created a shortcut. And this means he's really closing in on Ed.
I am utterly determined to win. This gully is the way that I'm gonna beat EJ. Ah! All right.
It's not bleeding.
No blood.
This has just become stupid and my ego is getting in the way and I want it to be successful. But it's not. We need to backtrack, get down the gully and rejoin the main channel of the river. The lead that I had over EJ, I'm sure, will have gone. He will have caught up and gone past.
Ed and EJ, they're running neck and neck pretty much. If I was a betting man, this is one bet that I would step back from. They're both very determined. They're both up for the challenge.
Going through that cave and just by happenstance finding the way to the other side, that was a huge gift for me today, because I would have been probably walking for miles to get around that thing. That's actually pretty good. A little bit like a cross between pork and chicken. That little guy packs a punch. Yeah, got some pretty good meat in there. Thank you, little buddy. I definitely needed this. This feels like another win. Tough day, but a good day.
I'd be really, really surprised if EJ wasn't ahead. It's all too tempting to just panic and just run. But actually, the way to win this is to eat well, build up my energies, and that's how I'm gonna beat him. Even though I'm moving fast through here, forever, I'm also looking out for little bits and bobs that I can stuff in my mouth. It's an ant's nest. There's a risk that they'll bite me, but I think that risk is worth taking. Wow, look at them swarming. I've been walking for days now without a proper meal, and I can eat as many of these ants as I like. All I've got to do is put up with the stings, which is worth it, because I can get a serious amount of protein in now. They do genuinely taste like sherbet. It's like lemonade. Ow. Ah. They do spray acid. Everyone that's biting me is gonna get eaten. Payback. Having said that, I did just smash their nest down.